Well, joining us live now via Skype from Vietnam is RP football team manager Dan Palami. Congratulations, first of all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Are you with your voice?
Sorry?
Are your voice there with you?
Are the boys are with me right now? I have Ali Borromeo, our captain.
Oh, great. Hello,
yeah. Oh, great. Hi. Here's Christopher Kamkam, one of our youngest players, who might just replace Neil Etheridge in the future. 16 years old and a 6'3 goalkeeper for the Philippines.
Hey, Ali, TJ here. Congratulations, buddy. You're the team captain. What is it like going up against a team that was the hometown favorite, the defending champions? I mean, what was it that atmosphere like in that game?
Honestly, it's still kind of surreal right now. It still doesn't hit us. And we're just looking forward to the next game against Myanmar in a couple of days.
All right. Well, I mean, how is the mood of the team? I mean, you can go on a high and, you know, be all happy with what you've achieved already, but are you all set in saying that you can beat Myanmar or at least draw and still go to the semifinals and bring this even further?
Definitely. We're taking the next step in that. Just getting to this tournament, we're looking to get points from Myanmar, but we didn't expect getting points from Vietnam and Singapore as well.
Well, wait, who's the young boy there? Who's the 16-year-old boy?
He's Christopher Kamkam.
Oh, Christopher.
Future of Philippine football.
Oh, move closer to the congratulations. You've become a sensation here in the Philippines, and we're all rooting for you. But how can you convince other kids like you to take up football? What's so great about it?
It's something I think that, like, you have to start liking as you're younger.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, it just grows. It grows as you play more.
Okay. All right, let's go to the team manager. We went for your boys first. What was the secret to this stunning victory?
Well, I think it's no secret at all. It's hard work and a big Filipino heart who never says surrender, never knows when to surrender, even against the indomitable odds that we had to face. So the boys are coming here, so it's going to be a bit noisy in a while.
Oh, they're all coming in?
They're all coming in.
Okay, well, we want to see them. Our audience wants to see them.
We're a bunch of guys.
Okay, so can each one say hello and...
I introduce to you our goalkeeper, which is Neil Etheridge.
Simon, we want to ask you, how did you feel about that being snubbed about the handshake by the Vietnam coach? It's all over Twitter here, the photos are going everywhere. He did also give his comments that, if we understood it correctly, he said that the Philippines plays awful. How do you react to that?
It's kind of a funny one, to be honest, because it upset me at the time, just simply because his only words to me at the end of us winning possibly the biggest game in our history, his only words of congratulations were, "I not shake your hands, you not a fair play guy," and that's something I don't. I may be fairly young to be in a job of this standing, but I won't take that disrespect off anybody. And for him not to shake my hand is, I think, more than anything, just a real lack of class and sour grapes on his side. I mean, I didn't really want to make a big deal of it. I went over to shake his hand and just congratulate him on a very hard fought game. There you go. What can you do about it?
So, Coach, we're asking you guys, what's your secret for your success? I did catch a bit of the video of your post-game press conference. You're talking about the passion of your team. And this is something we see across the board in every sport that Filipinos exhibit, whether it's in in boxing, in billiards, or now even in football, there's something about the Filipino athlete that's just something else. You've been around the world, you've seen football players from different nations. What can you say about the Filipino football player?
There is a definite strong will to succeed within the Philippines. What we find here is that because there's quite a strong military influence as well, you tend to be able to say one thing and it's done. You don't really have to revisit it too many times, just because of the nature of some of the boys we have here. But in general, we have a team that is prepared to give 100% every game. And it's my job to try and find that 100% in the motivational talks before the game. And luckily enough, in the last two games, we've been able to play at that. You know, every time we set foot on the field, we're given 100%. And I think if we continue to do that, as I said to the boys, that needs to become a weapon that we can bring, in that we can switch it on and off. We can go to war and give 100% against anybody at any time.
Coach, obviously the morale of your boys are very high. We can see them behind you. Would you like to introduce my players? And this is your chance. One by one.
So, let me move out of the way and introduce myself.
Okay, they ran away, but they were all congregating there.
If they're not the star, they'll hang around. Okay,
and who is this?
This is Neil Etheridge, our goalkeeper.
All right.
Okay. Hey, we have a question.
Can we bar Neil again?
Can we borrow Neil again?